then I was just going quietly about my business, making a review for the Godway EXN, when all of a sudden, Veteran decided to drop a bombshell of a newsflash for their up and coming follow up to their insanely successful debut wheel from 2020, and that is, of course, the Veteran Sherman. This week, let's talk about the Veteran Abram, what were very likely to be the hottest electric unicycle of 2021. Are you ready? Roll the intro. As always, if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe and click on that bell icon to be notified of new episodes. First, a quick shout out to E-Rides for sponsoring this video. If you are in the UK or AU and are thinking about putting a pre-order for the Veteran Abram, check out the video description below for a link, and Afiz is your man. There are little doubt that the Veteran Sherman was the most successful electric unicycle of 2020. Kuji's review of that wheel on YouTube currently sits at a cool 4 million views, and for many EUC riders, the Veteran likely still represent the absolute holy grail when it comes to promise that the EUC platform can bring an agile, convenient, and deceptively compact electric vehicle that is also capable of mind-boggling amount of power and speed. Veteran took the winning formula that Godway had perfected with the M Super line of wheels and improved it in every single aspect, and more importantly, shown an awareness of what it is that the enthusiast EUC rider had truly wanted. The end result was a wheel that didn't dwell on what the EUC platform was capable of, but what it aspires to. The Sherman was a wheel that truly shined when pushed above 35 miles an hour, a speed that wheels from King Song and InMotion weren't even capable of reaching till quite recently. So extreme was this aspiration that when I first rode it last year around June, I thought that there would have been no way for it to attract the attention of the general EUC riding public, whom for the most part at the time considered this kind of speed to be irresponsible and dangerous. Little did I know how wrong I would turn out to be in the end. Instead, the Veteran Sherman built an entire mythos of its own and attracted a whole new generation of EUC rider to whom the pursuit of joy was very much hardwired to speed. And I certainly gave it a glowing review at the very outset, and despite the skepticism that many New York riders had of the Sherman in the beginning, I was 100% for it right from the start. But unlike every other electric unicycle riding YouTuber, Marty, Chooch, Adam, Mick, and of course Kuji, I never bought one. Because there's just one flaw with the Veteran Sherman that I find personally difficult to accept. Given the latest review from Veteran, it would seem that they agree as well. A week ago, this image appeared with the promise of more information to come. Then Marty reached out to Jason at eWheel, who was the exclusive distributor for Veteran in the US, and were able to get a bit more information on it. Most important of which is probably this, that yes, this is real and comes from Veteran. It wasn't just a rendering from some talented industrial designer. And yes, we are looking at the next iteration, apparently to be called Abram, following the tank thing that they have established with the Sherman last year. There was an immediate uproar over the price, $3,700 for a wheel with only 2,700 watt hour of battery. The accountant among us immediately pegged it as being overpriced since it had exceeded the dollar per watt hour rule. And that came from the hobbyist perspective of seeing an electric unicycle as merely a collection of parts conveniently pre-assembled, but should not cost more than the combined value of all their components. Design and engineering don't really come into play at all, since specification was the only thing that really matters. This was how we end up with wheels that look like a cockroach and battery pack that spontaneously ignite if you look at them the wrong way. Minimizing the assembly cost means crappy design and worse QCs.
I don't get how this could have happened, man.
But time, they have been changing. The original veteran Sherman was thought of as being too expensive when it was first introduced at $2,800 last year. But not only was it wildly successful, even after the price was raised to $3,500 earlier this year to reflect component costs, it continues to sell out. But just as the diehard Apple fan who happily paid double the component cost of an iPhone, I suspect the fan of the veteran Sherman also feel that its value was worth more than the sum of its parts. The battery size was puzzling, since honestly, I think it would actually be easier for veteran to just simply keep their base component list and maybe just make some modest improvement, like, I don't know, cosmetic upgrades. I mean, if they have taken that shiny, beautiful shell in the rendering that they have produced and put it over the old veteran Sherman and still charge $3,700, I don't think anyone would complain. But instead, they choose to tackle the much more difficult problem of a bigger wheel. There had always been compromises when it comes to the larger wheel electric unicycle. My problem with the Sherman is simply that its 19-inch wheel is too small. It's fine for lower speed up to about 40 miles per hour, but more than that, you really need a larger diameter wheel to deal with unexpected road conditions. Sure, you're fine if you got perfect road surfaces wherever you go, but I don't, so screw you! But all it would take is one unexpected pothole or bump and you'd be in deep trouble. I've been spending a lot of time with the EXN lately, and it is certainly capable of hitting 50 miles per hour like the veteran Sherman. However, at least for me, it was very much a wide knuckle experience at speed above 45 miles per hour. Exciting, yes, but sketch as hell. There is a reason why motorcycles typically run larger tires, especially up front. And also why the fastest electric unicycle right now is the Monster Pro with a 24-inch tire. Because of the greater weight associated with a larger tire, motor, and rim assembly, a larger wheel in general require more power to spin up. As a result, they tend to suffer from either low torque output or generally lower top-end speed. For instance, although the original Monster had much better acceleration than the Monster Pro, it had to be capped at a yawn-inducing 38 miles per hour. The challenge had always been finding a balance between weight, power, and speed, and so far, Gotway had not had any major success with either of their entries. And I had guessed that they may have been running up against the inherent limitation of current-gen technology, which makes the latest drop from the veteran particularly interesting. It actually says off-road on the side, which in the EUC universe translates to higher torque output. How the hell do you squeeze out more torque, especially when you got a much larger 22-inch wheel that you gotta drag with your motor? There's just one way I could think of to achieve this, and that is to up the voltage. One of the huge advantages Gotway achieved early on was the transition to 100 volt. Through the higher voltage power supply system, they were able to achieve greater motor power output, both in terms of torque and top end speed, and they have maintained that lead until quite recently. There had been rumor of interest in developing the 117-volt system, but again, because of their monopoly with the 100-volt wheels, Gotway haven't had the motivation to push ahead until now. the same reason if Vedder were able to successfully engineer a 116-volt wheel and extract the promised next level of speed and power output from such a design, a 22-inch Abram with a smaller battery rating would make perfect sense if that was the case. And as an additional cherry on top, be quite the middle finger to their prior employer, Gotway. And in that scenario, a 116-volt, 60-mile-per-hour capable wheel would certainly go a long way in justifying the $3,700 ask. Despite the lower battery rating, and I am certain that it will once again set the EUC world ablaze. For me at least, this is tremendously exciting news since I have long been a diehard fan of the Gotway Monster and maintain that a 22-inch wheel is likely a much better wheel size than even the 19-inch that is most common currently, since you can still build a reasonably portable wheel while still provide significantly more stability and safety at speed. And although it is right on edge of what our current gen tech can support, I wouldn't be surprised if Vedder is able to engineer a much more compelling wheel that would out-monster the monster. Or should I say, Abram. The other curious news is Vedder is rumored to be stopping production on the Sherman to fully commit itself to the production of the Abram. That is a whole lot of confidence that they're placing on this wheel. And on the off chance that any of the wonderful folks at Vedder is watching this, and I'm gonna say this, the House of Vedder was built on speed, with the foundation being the Sherman. Whatever you do, please, please, please do not make this wheel slower than the Sherman. If this is to be the successor of the Sherman, it must be faster. Vedder has got to know that. Now, how they're going to cash this tremendous check that they have just wrote with this drop, a high-speed, high-torque wheel at 22-inch. All I can say is that I'm 100% looking forward to knowing Vedder and what they had achieved with the Sherman. I have little doubt that it's going to be something absolutely amazing. I hope so. I don't know, but I've been told. Music make you lose control. So what do you think? Have Vedder finally gone mad with power and jumped the shark with a pig that is too expensive with too teeny of a battery? Or is the 22-inch wheel the future of electric unicycle? That is what the comment section below are for. Shout out to my supporter on Patreon. Please check out the link in the video description below if you enjoy and like to support my work. And as always, as much as we all love electric unicycle, the only way for us to get better wheel is for us to grow as a community. So tell your friend, teach him how to ride, and get them hooked. Until the next video, thank you. Music make you lose control. Work your body to the beat.